Welcome back. Today we are going to be tackling somebody that is on my bucket list of content creators I would like to address, Rebecca Watson. I'm sure most of you or some of you have heard of this lady, as she was around during the time, or relevant during the time, of Gamergate. Not so much now, but that's not surprising really. If I'm going to be doing a video on Rebecca Watson and The Independent, I'm going to need a sandwich. Oh, Liz.
As a woman, I must do my duty now. I must make a sandwich for our god, Omegon. But what kind of sandwich would me, Liz, a cancerous person in the world? I know! I'll make him my specialty. A meat flappy beef sandwich. First you gotta get some buns, then you gotta get some nice flappy meat, a little mayonnaise for texture, don't forget the cheese, make sure it doesn't stink. Here you go, Omegon! Catch! You now have your very own meat flap Liz sandwich. I hope it was good enough for my gracious lord. Omegon.
Yeah, that was pretty good. Please go subscribe to Liz Reptile. Channel link in the description. Anyway, take it away, Rebecca.
Study says are two of the most powerful words in journalism because you can write pretty much whatever you want in front of those words in a headline and people will take it as the gospel truth.
I'm not entirely sure why you had to put study says in quotations, but you do actually have a point. Which is why the media has to go to such extraordinary lengths to conjure up these amazing titles, just to get people interested enough to read their newspapers, to listen to their stories. Which is why study says media trust is at an all-time low.
For instance, I could say, It's a Wonderful Life is the most overrated film of all time, study says.
I'm just going to make one minor change to what you just said, just so what you say is somehow valid.
For instance, I could say,
My porno
is the most overrated film of all time, study says.
Much better.
Bam. See? Believable.
Totally.
I mean, it's believable because it's true, but it's also more believable because a study seems to say it, even though there is no study.
While no studies actually exist of this, and you are right, there are none, and let's face it, it would be a waste of money to have them. That particular film does feature not your porno. It's a Wonderful Life features quite highly on Rotten Tomatoes, but also every year they do these greatest films of all time, the Christmas ones anyway, and It's a Wonderful Life features regularly at number one. Unsurprising, I guess. But it does surprise me that someone like yourself would mention that film as one of the greatest of all time, because every year I see someone mention how sexist Christmas songs are, how sexist Christmas outfits are, how sexist Christmas movies are. I'm surprised you'd mention this film at all. Maybe it's just an example. I'm overthinking this, aren't I? Carry on.
Which brings us to a headline that I recently read in The Independent, a fairly respectable newspaper.
For saying that, I'm going to loop this next little bit 5 times for lols. Worth it.
And the headline read, and I quote, "Celebrity feminists are making people care less about women's rights," study claims.
That is a bit of an unusual title, in truth. But that said, if you are getting to the point where you don't really have to think of women's rights so much, then is it that you don't care about them or that they've been attained? I'm just thinking off the top of my head here. Now, I do, before we continue, want to have a look at the article that you mentioned and the study that is claimed. It's never been trendier to be a feminist. Seemingly every other day, another influential celebrity is speaking out about the gender pay gap, double standards and female empowerment. It's always fascinating though that those that speak about the pay gap are normally the super rich, which is interesting because you've got Emma Watson, who's worth millions, but then underneath Jennifer Lawrence here putting pen to paper in response to Trump's victory. We will keep educating ourselves and working twice as hard as the man next to us because we know now that it is not fair. Interesting for one of the highest paid actresses in the world to talk about how it's not fair. It's a shame you don't know how the electoral system works, I guess. And no, this is not another Trump video, for God's sake. This is not another Trump video. Even famous feminist Taylor Swift has spoken out about the importance of fellow celebrities raising awareness. Taylor Swift was bullied into it after she said she wasn't one, and the only reason she says she is now is because it doesn't hurt her brand. She's not that stupid. It's why she didn't make it clear who she was voting for. Now, rather than reading the rest, because you actually address it in your video, let's go to you and dissect what you say along with the article, see if there's anything you say that is in fact incorrect or correct. I'm more than willing to accept when you say something correct.
Oh dear, if a study claims it, it must be true.
Good enough for me. Wait, no. Carry on.
The article explains that Jitender Sedef carried out a study over 2 years involving 6,000 adults around the world.
Now that I know the study was conducted with 6,000 people across the world, I have to say this study is going to be hugely inaccurate for a whole host of reasons. And I actually hope you agree with me on this, because there's no way any logical person can say, even with all the hard work put into it, that study can be truly representative. All the different countries, all the different populations, all the different cultures, all the different societies and communities. It just doesn't. It cannot.
Showing that, and I quote, if a celebrity hasn't demonstrated their commitment to the feminist cause before speaking out about it, 80% of people won't buy their feminist credentials.
If I was just a bit more of a dickhead, that would be a fantastic quote to mine. I will say before we continue that the idea of feminist credentials and proving one's credentials is such an annoying thing to hear, as if it's not enough that someone has been either bullied into it or has been misled into accepting it as gospel, but they must prove they believe. It's like you have to commit a sacrifice to the gods, the elder gods, this god, I'm a god. Believe me. Sorry, getting off track. Massive tangent. Sorry about that. Please continue.
Hold on. Actually, that's quite reasonable and doesn't track at all with the headline.
Shocker. A newspaper went with an article title that would get people interested in reading it. How very surprising.
Also, according to the article, apparently 20% of people reported that they care more about feminism thanks to a celebrity speaking out about it, which is also quite a positive.
Yeah, monkey see, monkey do. It's the basic concept of people seeing others do something and enjoy or succeed or embrace and do well from it, so they themselves decide that they want to. But as the number of, I would say, critical thinkers rises, that number is going to hopefully start to go down.
It's also interesting to note that the article reports 30% of people in the study cared less about feminist issues specifically because of Taylor Swift.
Who would have believed it? Someone who got bullied into accepting something, so then they themselves started to act like they believed in it. Are they not being bullied for saying they are it after being bullied into believing it, because they haven't proven themselves that they believe it to the masses that don't believe they believe it? Does that make sense?
I find it fascinating for three reasons. One, because feminism is generally understood by feminists to be the concern of women's equality. And if you care less about women's equality because of one woman you don't like, what does that say about your values in the first place?
I think in this instance it means they were more of a Calvin Harris fan, Tom Hiddleston fan, and every other ex-boyfriend fan, rather than Taylor Swift fan. Also, everyone understands that the definition of feminism is for women's equality. Everyone, not just feminists. I do feel I have to correct you on this one, because you did just say generally understood by feminists. But then your movement is so now heavily divided. And I will mention it multiple times. White feminism and intersectional feminism are the same bloody thing. It's just an excuse to divide, create more problems for the sake of it.
Number two, this makes me wonder exactly what definition of feminism Sedef used in his research. That's really important.
Yeah, I've searched for this paper everywhere, and I can't find it. In fact, much like you mentioned in your blog, and you included the link, we got the same result. I even went so far as to contact via Twitter the author of the article and the writer of the supposed study. Since a study has not been provided, I can dismiss its value, along with any credibility that article may have had itself. But you do mention something interesting, and that's with the reference to definition of feminism. And this is because very recently I addressed somebody who used the 2012 definition. The 2012 definition of feminism is not the same as the current definition. If he did 2 years research, chances are it was not the same definition, but then you're probably going to be going down the path of white feminism and intersectional feminism, which is going to drive me insane.
Was he asking people about women's equality, or was he asking about the particular brand of white feminism that people like Taylor Swift pay lip service to while being criticized constantly by intersectional feminists?
While I agree with most of your complaints about this particular study and article, your question, was he asking about women's equality, seems kind of redundant when you asked about women's rights and the definition of feminism he used, as all the definitions include women's rights as the main focal point, as it should. Now, in regards to your comments about the lip service and the particular brand of feminism, white feminism, let's say the study exists, you have to wonder what the reach was within the four continents and which countries and cities this study was conducted in. Now, without the study, it should be dismissed and this article removed, as it is defamatory and intellectually dishonest to make assertions without the evidence. Hardly a surprise, though, that The Independent would be the place that this happens. I also want to address your criticism of white feminism. I will accept that the larger known advocates for feminism are white women, but this does not mean they do not stand for all feminist values. It is just an excuse to hide blatant jealousy and pettiness under a banner that makes you feel like their contributions are somehow only benefiting a particular demographic. You yourself are a white feminist. What are your credentials to being an intersectional feminist, and how does it differ from white feminism, really?
Finally, it makes me wonder how 30% of all respondents both know who Taylor Swift is and care that much about what she has to say, considering that SEDEF claims the research spanned at least 4 continents, including Southeast Asia and Latin America, where Swift doesn't have nearly the presence she has here in the United States.
In this instance, I'd have to say you're wrong, as her last 2 albums have managed to be certified in countries like Mexico, Brazil, Venezuela, and South Korea. Maybe it's not as large as it would be in North America or Europe, but it still requires promotion, it still requires touring, it still means that she has influence and pull in those nations. Then again, this is all conjecture. Without seeing the study, it's redundant. I'm not entirely sure how many more times I can repeat that.
This also makes SEDEF's list of most and least credible celebrity feminists a little bit suspect.
The lack of study is suspect enough, but we should in fact have a little look at the most credible and least credible feminists. I am going to be honest, I don't know 2 of the top 5, but the one that stands out like a sore thumb is Lena Dunham. Now, you earlier mentioned credentials. Who on earth approved credentials for Lena Dunham? If she's done even half the things she mentioned in her book, which was remastered, you wouldn't want that kind of person associated with your movement. It's certainly in the case of fighting for gender equality that you already have. Now, off the top of my head, I'm going to go ahead and make up 5 excuses why the least credible feminists are the least credible. Adele, because she's a mother first. Renee Zellweger, because she's irrelevant. Olivia Wilde, again a mother. Taylor Swift, because she only agreed to be one because it protected her brand. And 5, Gigi Hadid. The interesting thing about Gigi Hadid is she's a bit of a model. So you have to wonder, how is she okay when her body's being objectified for a living? I'm done making up excuses. Let's hear what else you have to say before I finish this.
All of these questions would be easily answered, of course, by looking at the actual study, something that I always do when reading about a study in a popular mainstream media outlet.
That is fantastic, and in fact something I can fully support. Granted, your motivation is through an intersectional feminist lens, an assumption made, of course. Mine is a non-feminist lens, and equality lens. But we both can unite under the idea that if no evidence is provided, this is intellectual dishonesty. The writer of that alleged study has not provided it, and we have both gone to lengths to try and find it, and I don't think it is appropriate that The Independent, a source you consider highly regarded and I consider to be utter trash, should then put out articles that are as clickbaity as a leafy title. While I do have criticisms towards yourself because of what you believe, my main focus of this video is to be critical of The Independent and of the writer of that study that no one can find, and some little bits you say, but mostly because of the white feminism nonsense and intersectional feminism nonsense. Thank you all for listening. I hope it wasn't too triggering.